Hey, our first award is really, really special to me. Our first award tonight is the Music Executive Award. Let's take a look at why Mike Kelly is the 2024 honoree.
Basketball was Mike Kelly's childhood dream, but music was in his DNA. Like his uncle Bob Jones, his award-winning cousin Bobby OJ, and his other uncle Melvin Jones, both of whom were inducted in the Black Radio Hall of Fame, the Milwaukee native took to the airwaves, most notably with KADO Texarkana and WAWA Milwaukee. Soon, Mike found his way to the programming department, rising to program director at KAPE San Antonio and leading the legendary KATZ St. Louis. Reluctantly leaving radio, he went to work for the record companies. On the label side, he also excelled. First in Dallas, boosting the airplay of Kenny G, Billy Ocean, Kashif, and the iconic Whitney Houston as regional promotion manager for the Arista label led by Clive Davis. Called to work at the legendary Motown Records, Mike found himself working with the Temptations, Smokey, Stevie, Johnny Gill, and Boyz II Men, again as regional director of promotion. Mike next took his talents to Mercury with a new job title, National Director of Promotion. Here he helped launch Vanessa Williams, Brian McKnight, and Black Sheep. During his 14 years as VP at Sylvia Roan's Elektra Records, he guided Gerald Levert, Keith Sweat, Missy Elliott, En Vogue, and Busta Rhymes, among many others, to chart-topping success. He extended that track record working with Eric Benet, Genuine, and Jaheim as National Director of Promotion at Warner Brothers. Next, he would tap in with Atlantic Records as Senior Director of Promotion. There, he broke barriers with rappers Wale, Meek Mill, and Rick Ross's Maybach Music Group, along with Jill Scott, Tank, Bruno Mars, Silk Sonic, and Jack Harlow. Today, Mike moves the needle with his own Real One 24/7 promotion and marketing company. The Living Legends Foundation proudly celebrates Mike Kelly's career of excellence with its Music Executive Award. Congratulations, Mike.
To present the award is Living Legends President. Y'all give it up for Azeem Rashid.
Listen, when we talk about the Living Legends Foundation, we talk about the preservation of the legacy of Black executives. Can't get no better than Mike Kelly. I would not be on this stage tonight without him. But to bring him up, we need to bring up the man who gave him his start, Mr. Melvin Jones and his daughter, Keona Lewis.
Thank you, Skip. Thank you, Azeem. Boy, I'm honored and humbled to introduce the next Living Legends Foundation honoree. His life has all the attributes of a Disney movie. He grew up in Milwaukee. I came to Milwaukee in 1971 to do afternoon drive at WAWA. He was in an unhealthy family situation because of an abusive stepfather. He was enduring mental, emotional, and psychological abuse. When I found out what was happening, I asked his mother if he could live with me. And she said yes. I told his mother that I would make sure he stayed in school. I tried to instill in him values like hard work, being faithful to family and friends, to think for himself, to love all people, to always stand on business, and that your word is bond. So he came to live with me at 12 years old. He was my driver at 14. I lived a rock and roll lifestyle in those days. He was exposed to the nightlife, but he was not that person. He stayed focused on school and basketball and was a good enough basketball player to receive a scholarship. But radio and records was his first love. He was mentored. I didn't know a lot of this. He and Bobby O.J. were roommates in my home for a time when Bobby lived with us, the late, great Bobby O.J. And he was mentoring our honoree, then hanging out at WLOK radio station where I was program director for many years. My brother, the real Bob Jones, mentored him, as well as Mr. B, Bernard Miller. As a teenager, he became very close to former Atlantic Records promotions executive, Miss Venice Starks. She was like a surrogate mother or big sister to him. And also he became very close to James Alexander of the Barquets. He's a family man, lovely wife Debbie here tonight, son Michael here tonight. And he's been a source of strength, inspiration, and encouragement to his daughter, Keona Michelle, a rising star in the music business. Keona, you got next. I am honored to introduce to you a living legend, a name you don't know, but a man you do know. The name you don't know is Bobby Lewis Jones. But the man you do know, his nom de plume, AKA Mike Kelly.
I want to thank the Living Legends Foundation for this amazing award. I want to thank the nominating committee that voted for me to receive this award also. As you heard, I got over 40 years in this business, and I just want to kind of give a couple names that's instrumental to me being up here tonight. You guys heard from my family, but outside of the family, as the late John Mosley, Dorian Cox gave me my first radio job. The late Dr. O.C. White and Jimmy Goodtime brought me back home to Milwaukee. Tom Pope brought me to San Antonio, made me a program director. Dale Spencer had me programming KTZ, AM, and FM. That's the radio side. On the record side, I want to put some names out there for you guys as well. The late A.D. Washington. Barbara Lewis, India Graves, Walter Moorhead, Belinda Wilson, and Eddie Sims. They were my first mentors when I jumped ship from radio to records. I want to thank, my first job came at Arista Records. I want to thank Tony Anderson, Doug Daniel was the national. My second job was like being in college. I want to thank Miller London, Ronnie Jones, Eric Thrasher, James Cochran, and Paris Ely. That's my Motown family. And with that success, I worked with Tony Anderson again. He gave me my first national job working for Ed Eckstein and also Gwen Franklin. For Mercury, I got a chance to work with the legendary Sylvia Rome. I love you, Sylvia. You changed my life in so many ways. Sylvia, Doug Daniels, Richard Nash, we had a great team. From there, I got a chance to work with my brother from another mother, Ken Wilson at Warner Brothers. And my career closed down at Atlantic Records. I want to shout out to Mike Kaiser, Juliet Jones, Kev Holiday, Damon Lott. Last but not least, I want to say hi. I want to say thank you to my wife Debbie, my daughter Kiona, and my son Michael. You guys are my reason, you are my why, and you are my life. I love you unconditionally. Again, thank you to the Living Legends for this award. And I got to close with my uncle's favorite radio closing. It's all in a day's work. You take care of your beautiful bod and have a good one.